So let's do something different now. Mm-hmm. So let's go to that paragraph that we had. So if you remember, we wrote down the paragraph as one word per card.
Kept so in the sequence, but kept in
yeah,
the sequence.
Now we have them in the same sequence. And what we had done was, I think we had put the punctuation with the word. So for instance, it was Monday morning. This was the first sentence.
Mm-hmm.
And the sentence ends with a full stop.
Full
so
stop.
The full stop was kept with the morning.
Mm-hmm.
So actually, we can go through this and we can kind of identify where the sentences end, provided of course it's in the correct order, which it is now. So now what can we do with this?
If you know where the sentence ends, then an interesting question that we can ask is what is the longest sentence in this paragraph?
Okay. So
what is the longest sentence means that longest defined as the one which has the most number of words, let us say.
Okay, so wherever a sentence starts, we should start counting the words.
Start counting the words.
Wherever a full stop comes, we
could also, of course, also count the longest sentence in terms of number of characters in the words and add it up. But for a moment, let's just count.
Okay, so let's count the words. So we start counting when we see a sentence starting. That means after a full stop, we start counting. When we hit a full stop, the sentence is over.
Over.
So we have a
count. We have the number of words in that sentence.
And then we
have. We have to keep that aside.
And keep.
And then we come to the second sentence, we have to start again, right? We have to,
yes.
Because it's a new sentence.
Correct.
And then we start counting again the words. And then when we hit a full stop at that point, again, we have a count for this sentence. So that count has to be kept aside.
So you are saying we have to keep a separate, remember the
count
of
for
each sentence. But
and then if there are four, five sentences, then we'll keep five counts, we'll keep like that. And then we'll take all those five counts and find out which of those counts is the highest, like what we did just now. We found the maximum total, like that we'll find which of the counts is the highest. And that will tell us.
Yeah, but if it's a very long paragraph, won't there be many counts? I don't know how many sentences there are in this. I think there must be a better way to do this.
What's a better way to do this? I mean, we have to keep track of the counts of all the sentences.
So when we were doing the marks, actually we only kept track of the maximum marks that we have seen so far. We only needed one variable. It didn't matter that there were 30 students in the class or 100 students in the class. We never needed to remember anything except compare the next mark
with the
previous maximum.
Maximum. So can we do that here? I mean, so which means that here we are looking for the maximum count, count being the number of words in the sentence.
Yes.
So if you are looking at the maximum count, then we need only keep that maximum count, maximum number of words in a sentence.
Yeah, so,
count.
So what I suggest is that we keep the
is
number
it?
Of words that we have seen so far, the longest sentence we have seen so far.
The words,
we remember
number of
number
words,
of words in that.
Yeah.
Then each new sentence, we count that sentence from scratch.
Okay.
We start from the beginning and
count it.
When we get a number for that sentence, we compare,
compare it with the...
Either we update it or we skip it.
Like we did earlier.
Yeah. So we never actually have to remember all the sentences.
We don't need to keep track of all the sentences in this one, this particular problem.
Yeah.
All right, okay. So let's try that.
Let's try that.
So what did we say we'll do? We'll start with a variable, which is...
Yeah. So let us
call it
longest.
Longest. Longest. And initially we need to set it to some value.
Let me call it longest sentence so we remember what it is. Okay.
Longest sentence.
So initially, let's say that it is zero because
zero,
we know that our
because
sentence
has to have at least one word. So
yes.
Zero, yeah. Okay, we can start with zero.
Yeah.
And I am going to go through the words. You tell me when we have hit the end of the sentence. And
yeah.
As we do this, we count. I
guess. Yeah.
So do we keep count in another card?
Yeah. So maybe I will do
that. So we need another variable. Call that count. Count is keeping track of the number of words we have seen so far.
Okay.
Right. We start with zero. Right.
Yeah. Sorry.
Zero.
Yeah.
All right. So we have first card.
Okay.
One. Second.
Two.
Third.
Three.
Next. Now this one has a full stop.
Four. Okay. So our first sentence has four words in it. And as far as we know now, this is the longest sentence because our earlier estimate was only zero.
Okay.
Right?
So we
so now we say the longest sentence has four words. Okay.
Now what do we do with count? Do we
we have
continue
to start
four?
Again.
We can't
no.
continue four because it's a new sentence, right?
Yeah. So,
so we just discard that earlier value of count and start with count equal to zero again. All right. So again.
One.
Next card.
Two.
Next card.
Three.
Next card.
Four.
Next card.
Five.
Next card.
Six.
This one has a next card has a full stop.
Okay. So we have seen seven words in this sentence.
Seven words in this sentence.
And our previous longest sentence had four words.
So now we can
replace
4 with 7.
Yes.
And again that count thing has to
get reset.
Be reset to 0 because we are seeing a new sentence now, right?
Yes.
Okay, we start again. 1. Next 1.
2.
Next.
3.
Next.
4.
Next.
5.
Next.
6.
Next.
7.
Next 1. This one has a full stop.
8. Okay.
So we got a slightly longer sentence, 8, all right?
Yeah.
So
I replace this length of the longest 7 by 8, mm-hmm. And right. Again we reset.
We reset count to 0 and then we can start again, right?
First 1.
Next.
2.
Next.
3.
Next.
4.
Next.
5.
Next.
6.
Next.
7.
Next. This is eight. A comma, not a full stop, okay.
Okay.
Next.
9.
Next.
10.
Next.
11.
Next.
12.
Next. Wow.
13.
Next.
14.
Next.
15.
Next.
16.
Next.
17.
Next.
18.
Next.
19.
Next.
20. I'm running out of space. Okay. So, it is 20. Right?
All right.
So this is of course much bigger than 8, which was our earlier longest sentence.
Mm.
So now we say that our longest sentence has 20 words.
All right.
Okay. So I now need to keep counting. So let's go back and for the next
set
sentence,
count to zero.
Set count to 0.
I doubt that there will be another sentence longer than this one, but let's see.
Let's
all right.
See.
First one.
1.
Next.
2.
Next.
3.
Next.
4.
Next.
5.
Next.
6.
Next.
7.
Next.
This 8.
Is colon. Next.
9.
Next.
10.
Next.
11.
Next. Semicolon. Next.
13.
Next.
14.
Next.
15.
Next.
16.
Next.
17.
Next. Comma.
18.
Next.
19.
Next.
20.
Next.
21.
Next.
22.
Next.
23.
Next.
24.
Next.
25. Okay. So the last sentence was actually the longest.
All right.
And it had 25. So in this way, what we have done is we have just been keeping track of the longest sentence, and each time we count a new sentence, we restart the counting process.
Hmm.
So we keep counting again and again. So we have one variable count, which we keep reusing. So although on the card it looks like we have kept track of the count of each sentence, each time we reset to zero, the previous count is lost.
Gone.
So we don't really know that the previous one is 20 or 8 or 7.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because we are just reusing. So we have two variables. We have the count variable which we keep restarting each time, and we have this longest sentence variable which is updated every time we see a longer sentence, just like we did for the maximum marks in the last case.
So this is a single iteration actually. In one iteration,
yes.
We have managed to find the longest sentence, keeping track with two variables, one which keeps a count of the number of words in the sentence, another which keeps track of the longest sentence you have seen so far.
Yeah.
And we didn't need to remember which sentence contributed to the longest number, right?
Yeah, the difference between the previous one and this one was there, the quantity we were counting the max was directly given to us in each card.
Hmm.
Whereas here
we had to
calculate that quantity by going across multiple cards. Then once we got it in one place, then we compare. So it's a little bit more complicated counting than the previous one. But still it just combines what we have seen so far, which is how to count cards and how to keep track of the maximum.
And the filtering also is very interesting here, because we are actually looking for the card which has a full stop in it. That is the first filter.
Yes.
The second filter is at that point we look at the value of the count.
Yes.
Which is a valuable variable actually now.
Yes.
So far we have compared a constant, the card with a constant. We have compared in the last one, we compared the value of the card with a
variable.
And now we are comparing the value of one variable
with another variable.
With another variable.
Okay. Okay,
right.
So we are getting slightly more complicated now in our computation. Very good, very good.
Yeah.